day, all. Ira Epstein of Linn & Associates with your metals market wrap-up for this particular Wednesday, but I'm late. I'm at 5:17 p.m. Central Daylight Time on June 5th, 2019, which means you're already looking at Thursday trade. Remember, the markets reopen at 5 p.m. I wanted to see if we had any news before I did this on how the Mexican-American talks were going on the tariffs. And I think the stock market's telling you right now that it's concerned that they didn't go well. I don't know if they went well or not. There's supposed to be a news conference soon about it. Out of the Mexican embassy will be one, and I imagine we'll see something from our side. But this market down like this is telling me that maybe it didn't go as well as we were all hoping on the first stage of it. Mike Pompeo met with Vice President Pence and then the Mexican delegation, their economic minister, their foreign minister. So we're going to find out a lot as to where this all goes. There'll be a lot of finger pointing, but watch that. Gold up on the news so far tonight. Silver up a little bit, and the copper market sort of just languishing lower. There's nothing helping the copper without these trade tariff wars going away. That is a problem. Energy prices got hit today pretty hard too, so it's lack of inflation. Gold is moving up on fear about the economy, not inflationary fears. When you take a look at a weekly chart of gold, you can see how the market has zoomed to the upside. We're up $25 at midweek in the gold. That's quite a bit that the market is up. By the way, if you go to our website and go under the word education and you go to special reports there, you'll see a special metal report. If you haven't looked at it, that's the gold report video that I just did for you. And I, by the way, we also fixed it. It'll play on your smartphones, your Android phone, should you look at it. We had a call in about that. We appreciate that. But as you look at the market, zooming to the upside, into the resistance areas that we've seen before. This is a big area that the market's got to overcome if it wants to really move to another level. When you look at how the market is tonight, you closed at the lower part of the day's range on Wednesday, still up on the day, and we're gaining a little bit more tonight. What I hate about this market is the fact that it's just a straight up move. So you've gone from 1279 to 1348. It's a $70 move, almost in a straight line in the marketplace. When you look at moving averages, the one thing that I'm looking to see is, does the 18-day average of closes start crossing over the 100-day? That would be called the bullish crossover. Right now, if the market were to just let go to the downside, I'd look for support in between 1309, the 100-day average, and the 18. To break the current pattern of bullishness, and I'm talking this current chart pattern, you'd have to take out 1279.20 to stop the pattern of higher lows and higher highs. In terms of the Bollinger Band, notice how the market pulled back tonight to that. Now, if you look at the close during the day, you were over it, over it, over it. So that's 3 days in a row, 4 days in a row. Is it going to have a fifth today? Don't know, but I would say that however the situation between Mexico and the U.S. goes will have a lot to do with that. When I look at momentum, you're overbought. So I have a market that's overbought, stretched out over the upper Bollinger Band, likely to pull back within that band. That's the words that I'd use. So now, where do you go? Look at my gold report, and I think you'll get an idea if you go to our website, www.iraepstein.com. In GLD, it's similar to the futures. You're stretching yourself out over the upper Bollinger Band. What's the theory there? In the Bollinger Band theory, these black dashed lines, the theory is the market will trade within the bands 95% of the time. Now, what the algorithm does with its mathematics is it adjusts during when the market's open, trying to get the market where the band will get within, in other words, get prices within that band. But generally, the first time you hit one of these bands is where resistance or support will show up. Eventually, sideways action creates a base or a top, and in this case, it looks like it's created a base. What you want to look at this week is how the monthly charts look at. Because you've ended one month, now you're starting another. We've been stuck going sideways on monthly charts, I want to say 5 years, something like that. Pretty long. GDX, what you want in a bull market often is for the mining stocks to lead it in gold. It's just tradition as to how this has typically worked. And these have broken out to the upside just the way that the futures and the ETF has done, GLD. Now the question is, does it pull back in here again? You've got this setup where I'm looking to see if the 18 and the 100-day averages come together. The market that's not responding well is the gold-silver ratio. It's pushing 90 to 1 at this point. When you look at July silver, all you did is get to the upper Bollinger Band finally. Here's how you looked on Tuesday. Remember, we're looking at Thursday trade already. For Wednesday, you got up to that number, and there's my theory. Does anything work all the time? Probably not. But when you look at how the market goes, I would expect that those that had, whatever manner, caught this bull play against that Bollinger Band, taking some money off the table, and it looks to me like that's what they did. The copper is fascinating in the sense that last night, Tuesday night, the market had lost the embedded reading. You closed at the top part of the range as well. Normally what that does, unless you get a big reversal, is it makes that number get even worse. I was at home watching it at that point, and the number moved from here, 25 to even a higher level initially, as the market made higher highs than yesterday. But then the market let go. And now that it's let go, it re-embedded. When it re-embeds, and that's what you're doing again tonight, you're putting back in the play, as I'll call it, right here, the lower Bollinger Band. What would negate my thinking on that? Taking out the highs of Wednesday would. If you were to take out this 267.45, that would take out the high of an outside day down. That often is a sign that the market has spent itself to the downside and at least will start churning, if not rally more. In the platinum market, we have a pattern of a lower low and a higher high. There's no trend. You're still oversold. You've been fighting at the 18-day average of closes. I don't know where tonight will end up, if it'll get back up and rally there or not. But as I said, a lot of this is going to look at these how the tariff situation is between the U.S. and Mexico. Look at how palladium's just sitting on the 18-day average. This is classic sideways action. And from here will come a trend, which way is obviously what we're going to try to work on. Right now, there's two levels of resistance, the 100-day average in green, the upper Bollinger Band, the neutral line that I call that line in the sand, the 18-day average is right here, and you can see in the Bollinger Band how you're going sideways. Momentum, slightly down, price action, trying to work down. If it were to take out the low right back here, this low, which was 1305, you'd give the bears a bit more ammunition, but right now as it is, it's still probably lower highs and higher lows. You're just stuck in no man's land. Last in the dollar index, what do we just say? This was the action on Monday. When a market gets, the first time it hits a upper or lower Bollinger Band is where often, I'm not gonna use the word always, often you'll see the market try to give a bit of a reversal. Yesterday, the market got to 96.90. The Bollinger Band was 96.91. It got through it, and today spun back up. It's no different than the expectation. If it continues to break from here, look for the possibility of the 100-day average as the next support. What else do you have on the chart? You have an outside day to the upside. So now if the market wants to rally, the 18-day average comes into play. The trend is down, lower highs, lower lows, but it is an oversold market. I talked about that, and I'll be talking in the morning about the impact of Mexico, U.S. trade, what's going on, do we have any resolution of this tariff war, does it get worse? The charts in the morning when I put them out are only available for subscribers. They look like this. They have a different color combination and more studies than I talk about here. And the rationale there is I can do a lot more on these charts. And the reason is when you're talking to the general public as a broker, you're restrained on what you can say. The government has certain rules and you can talk generalities of trends. But when I want to say buy here, sell there, do that, it's got to be protected in some manner, with be it a subscriber, be it behind passwords, whatever it is. That's just the way that it works, and that's fine. But what I do in the morning, specific trade ideas, I will say buy right here, right now. I will say here's the stop, Here's what I'm looking for. Here's how I'd play this embedded reading. Here's some option strategies for down the road. And I've done that before. Example, in the hog market, I had talked to traders, call your broker. I thought call strategies for next year's pig crop is something to look at, maybe even the December. Too soon right now is what I had told people, but there's no motive for China to start changing their tune with the US just yet. But when it happens, we'll see that in the marketplace. So I offer all this and give you ideas in the morning. And the reason I do it early, I record at 6:15 a.m. Central Daylight Time. And the reason is at 7:30, we have government reports typically, and I'm dealing Central Time, coming out. I want you to have a feel for them. I want you to know what Europe's done already and what I'm seeing for the trade going into that morning session. So if you're sitting on a sideline, you're going, huh, he sees what I'm seeing, or no, he's seeing something I don't see. You can make up your own mind from that. The price that I do charge for it, 26.5 cents a day to get you started for 30 days. After that, if you want it, you continue. It can be $15 a month, or you can buy it at $13 a month. You pay up front $156 for the year. I think you'll find, if I can throw out one idea that helps you with your trade, that's not a big price to pay in these markets. You can go to our website, www.iraepstein.com, under education or research. We've got Ira's morning subscriber video. It'll take care of you the rest of the way. I'm Ira. You have a good day.